Welcome back to the Regenerate channel. GITech sent me a link to a very cool post he made over on Reddit showing the Cemu community the effects of utilizing ReShade to apply new shader settings to various Wii U games running in Cemu. It's an interesting read and I'll post the link below in the description for everyone wanting to go check it out. After going over the post, spending some time playing with ReShade myself, and speaking with GITech about it, I thought it would be useful to have a basic tutorial showing the community just how simple it is to set up ReShade to run with Cemu, and how to properly apply the settings that GITech was using in his post. Of course, this also leaves room for community members to experiment, so once you've gone through the tutorial, please feel free to share different shader settings that you've discovered or created down in the comments below, or head over to our Discord server to share with the community there. Without wasting any more time, let's get right into it. This is how to set up ReShade for Cemu. Step 1. Step 1, of course, is to have the most recent version of Cemu. If you don't have it yet, head over to cemu.info to download the latest version. If you already are running Cemu, I suggest for testing purposes that you make a copy of your Cemu directory or start with a fresh install so that just in case anything gets messed up, none of your files will be messed with and you can simply start over from scratch. Step 2. Assuming that you have all of your save game data, graphic packs, and transferable shader cache data copied over to your new directory, the next step is to head over to the ReShade website and download it. Follow the link in the description below to download ReShade. Next, head over to GITech's Reddit post, the link is also found in the description, and download his Mario Kart 8 shader settings. Once it's all downloaded, copy the files over to your emulation directory and extract the files here. Step 3. Open the ReShade.exe. You'll be face to face with a small box that welcomes you and prompts you to select a game. Click on the Select Game button and search for your Cemu ReShade testing directory that we set up, and select Cemu.exe. The welcome message will now change to tell you that it's installing to Cemu. The Select Game box will now say Select Rendering API. This is the application programming interface that communicates with your GPU to manipulate shader data. Click on OpenGL to continue. A prompt will be presented asking you if you'd like to download a collection of the standard effects for ReShade. Click on Yes. ReShade will now download and then ask you which effect files you'd like to install. You can pick and choose from the list. GITech advises not to install all of the shaders for a couple of different reasons. First, the more shaders that you have installed in the ReShade shaders directory, the longer Cemu and ReShade will take to compile everything at startup. And second, having cartoon.fx file in the directory seems to have caused some people issues in MK8, resulting mostly in black screens. For this reason, it's suggested that you install the specific ones listed and linked in the image link below in the description. But for the sake of simplicity, and for those wanting to live life a little more dangerously.
I also like to live dangerously.
As you wish, sir.
Just install them all like I have here, and click on OK. ReShade is now properly installed into your Cemu directory. Step 4. Close the ReShade installer, and then head into your Cemu directory and take a look at what ReShade did. We now have a couple of new OpenGL.dll files, as well as a new ReShade shaders directory. We want to copy and paste GITech's shader config file into our Cemu directory. For simplicity's sake, I've renamed the file to MK8, and I will paste the INI file at the root of the Cemu directory. But to keep things clean, you'll want to place it into one of the above shader directories and leave the descriptive file name. Step 5. Open Cemu and load your ROM file. As soon as your game loads, hit Shift and F2 to configure ReShade. Tell ReShade where your configuration file is that we downloaded previously and its name. Again, I renamed mine to mk8.ini. Hit enter and then continue. Step 6. There are a few settings and tweaks you'll want to make sure to have in order before you start playing your game. You'll want to ensure that your shaders are in the proper order for performance reasons. I've included a link in the description to an image which will show you the proper order, but you'll also see that order by default here in this video. If you like to save screen caps, you should consider changing the default screen cap type to PNG. This will save considerable hard drive space over time with a smaller file size. Next, it's good to know that ReShade has an Fps Overlay feature. You can find that here as well. Once you're done making the changes that you want in ReShade, make sure to change from configuration mode into performance mode, as it will really help increase your general performance. And it's really as simple as that. There are many who will have no issue figuring this out on their own, but for those of you who have made it this far, I hope that this has served as an intro into what ReShade is capable of, and I hope that you have fun playing around with the settings. Again, please share your own settings and config files with the rest of the community if you come up with anything really special. A very big thank you goes out to GITech for sending this to me, and for his willingness to collaborate with me on getting this information out to the Cemu community in a more accessible video format. Cheers, mate. Keep up the great work. That's all for now. I'll leave you with a comparison footage of GITech's ReShade settings versus the default shaders for Mario Kart 8 in Cemu. Until next time, have fun, game on, and remember, don't forget to smile.